Okay, so we're supposed to seek good. Let me tell you, Nahum said this. The prophet Nahum, and this is not a rumor, this is the word of God. He said, God is good.
Amen.
You want to seek good? Seek God.
That's right.
And seek Him, Isaiah said, Isaiah 55, it says, seek the Lord while He may be found. Call upon Him while He is near. You don't have to be a Bible scholar, a theologian, or a rocket scientist to figure out that what Isaiah was saying is that there will be a time when He will not be found. There will be a time when He is not near. If He is warning you, seek Him while He may be found. Call upon Him while He is near. The fact of the matter is, most false religions have a cyclical view of history and time. It just keeps going around and around and around. It goes around and around and around. What was different with the Jews, which carries on into Christianity, and I believe even the Muslims have the same thing, they have a linear view of history. There is a starting point. The starting point, by the way, is Genesis 1:1. In the beginning. There is a beginning. I don't care what scientists say, what anybody else says. You know what? You want to know my view on evolution? You want to know my view on science? In the beginning, God created. That pretty much sums it up for me.
That sums up Earth Day yesterday, too.
Yeah, that sums up Earth Day. Yeah. But there's also an end. There is a beginning and there is an end. It doesn't just keep going around and around and around.
Mm-hmm.
If there is an end, and there's an appointed time for every event on heaven,
yes.
I don't know when that end is coming. Nobody does, yeah. By the way.
Although
we can see the signs. That's what Jesus Christ said. He said, when you see these signs, rejoice, for you know that your salvation draws nigh, draws near. Well, I believe I see those signs that Jesus spoke of, and I know that His salvation is drawing near. But that means that the clock is ticking. Tick-tock, tick-tock, tick-tock. We're running out of time.
That's right.
We're running out of time. So you need to understand that we're called to seek good, seek God, while you can. Because there will come a time when you can't. I talked about God speaking to people and saying, okay, there's a time to stop talking. You know that one of the prophecies is that there will be silence in heaven, that there will be a famine for the Word of God. This is serious stuff. So we need to use and make the most of the time that we have to use that opportunity. To redeem the time, especially as the end grows near, especially as the time grows near.
We need to be out there begging them.
To be reconciled to God. We need to be sharing the love of Jesus Christ with people. We need to be telling people that, you know, boldly proclaiming the love of God. Jesus Christ died on a cross. That was God publicly displaying, God the Father publicly displaying His love. Expressed and manifest through His Son, Jesus Christ. We need not to be ashamed of that cross. Because you see, what happens is when it says that the word of the cross is foolishness to those who are perishing. But to us who are saved, we know it's the power of God unto salvation. We need to be proclaiming the cross of Jesus Christ and not ashamed of the cross of Jesus Christ. Because the time is evil and the time is running short.
Come unto Jesus.